skills. You ain't gotta tell me, I know I'm ill. Star is treacherous, I effortlessly show them skills.
Playing skills, you did. Playing skills. Ice on the wrist, car on the wrist, hole in the wrist, watch out flip, watch out whip, I'm in the whip, hole in the wrist, I never switch, ice on the wrist, car on the wrist, hole in the wrist, watch out flip, watch out whip, I'm in the whip, hole in the wrist, I never switch, ice on the wrist. I get the money, but I never switch. They saying you switch, you won't do it. You know they came from the bottom, and now we is lit. You is lit. I gotta get it, I gotta get it. You hatin' cause I still no risk. Why bitch you wanna be famous, They L.A. they made us, You know I'm icy in Vegas. This for the haters, I make a lot of new money, When the not save us, You be liking my flavor, I think it's cause I still no risk.
Okay, Coach, well, the holiday rush, that's in full swing in nearby Manhattan, but we've got football here 8 miles west at MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey. A few moments ago, the crowd here was on their feet as their beloved Jets made their way out of the tunnel. They're ready to go, we're ready to go, and it should be a good one as those New York Jets get set to face off with the Miami Dolphins. Fairly short kick, taking it to 14 here. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line.
The Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own 29-yard line.
Mike Jeanette, 180.
This is Kenyon Drake, the fourth-year man from Alabama. Big Leonard Williams there on the stop.
Well, I think that's what they're going to need to do here in the first half. You've got to take some pressure off of this young quarterback, and no better way to do it than to establish the running game early.
At the 33-yard line.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six.
Get ready.
Running, it's Drake. And oh, right away, he lost the football. And it's scooped up by the Jets. And his guys are going to get the football at the 37-yard line. Opening drive fumble, and the four miscues that they had last week. Four turnovers, Charles. So this is a bad trend.
And Brandon, you and I both know that they didn't just ignore what happened last week. They focused on it, tried to get better. And when it happened,
blitz coming, and down he goes. Give the sack to Jerome Baker.
Okay, partner, a couple points of interest right here, all right? Offensively, we see that they came out throwing the football, but maybe more importantly, the blitz that came defensively, they got right after them.
And you were telling me pregame before we came on air, you think this is something we could see a lot.
Yeah, there's no doubt about it because this is a unit that wants to play the game on their terms. Well, that didn't appear to be a run blitz. He just darted in once he saw the run develop. That appeared to be a case of see ball, get ball.
Looking for Crowder, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Rashad Jones. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. Not a good omen there. His first throw of the afternoon, intercepted.
And I know what the fans are thinking right now. I hope there's not negative thoughts in his head going forward since that's his first throw of the game. But one of the things I remember about him coming out of school is he's able to wipe things away pretty easily and move on.
A run on first down, but it's not going to get him much. Maybe a yard, and that's all. The tackle by Tremaine Johnson.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. On the toss play, this is Drake. And he's got some space here. There he goes, left side. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Kenyon Drake, his 11th touchdown of the year, as his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. And on that long run, maybe the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes.
Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 to score as they start first and 10. Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. He was looking for Jamison Crowder there, and that'll bring up second down. Now Darnold. And this is going to wind up incomplete. The coverage there too strong on the deep ball, and now they face a third down. And this passing game's whole offense really didn't show up in the loss last week, and it hasn't started all that great here either.
Yeah, and they can't let that incompletion become an uh-oh moment. Like, oh boy, here we go again, just like last week. Each game is its own entity, treated as such.
And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. Give him 15 yards on that one, and the Jets move the chains. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Throwing again is Darnold. And this will be incomplete. Physical play on the football there, and it's second down.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
This is Bell. Looking for an opening, not much there. He'll get it to the 39.
And that's one of the reasons you like to blitz even on rundowns. It confuses the blocking assignments. It doesn't allow those offensive linemen to get up to the second level.
Throwing here on third down. Darnold being chased out left. He may try and run for this. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 14 yards is the pickup there and a Jet first down.
I'm not sure he falls under the category of mobile quarterback, but he's athletic enough that if you don't keep your rush lanes intact, he finds a way to hurt you.
As coaches like to say, I wouldn't call him a burner, but enough there in the tank. And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
And that's one he's got to be happy to have back. There wasn't a hole open in the zone.
You'd have to think on early downs like that first down there, need to be a little bit more careful.
Yeah, fortunately for him, got a couple more downs to play with.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
It's a lot of contact going on there, and in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. Here comes the eighth play of the drive, and they need a full 10 yards on third down. Darnold from the gun. Gets this one to Le'Veon Bell. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 36.
And this is why trying to cover the angle route is so difficult. Anyone playing the linebacker position, when they see a running back out of the backfield widen because he heads towards the flat first, oftentimes you widen too much and overcommit.
And a sack. They get to him defensively, but the flag comes in, and I think the D jumped. Well, we looked at each other right when he flinched. We knew that that flag was coming.
Yeah, offsides, easy call. Mark off the five and keep it moving.
To the air again, Darnold. Crowder's got it over the middle. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Now after the completion, we're going to get a timeout, an injured player. We'll check on his status when we get back. First red zone opportunity now for the Jets. It's first and 10 from the 12. Again, Darnold. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
Coverage was very good that time. A nice job to smother him as the ball arrived, and that ensured an incomplete pass.
And it keeps 6 points off the board. So after the incompletion on first, now second and ten. From the shotgun, it's a give to Bell. He'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about 3.
You got it.
We haven't seen much from him running the football here in this first quarter.
No, you're right about that. We haven't seen much of him at all so far. They've stacked him up pretty well, but when you're trying to run the football, sometimes you got to play the long game. Keep handing it to him, and some of those runs that aren't working now, they turn them aside.
And they're going to get him. They bring him down to the sack back at the 16-yard line.
Well, it's about how teams are so competitively matched, and you just want to make those plays that give you an advantage. How about right here? The difference between letting them score a touchdown versus holding them to a field goal, that's absolutely huge with the play he just made.
And you know he hated taking the loss there on third down. So they get the field goal, but that was a 14-play drive to get through.
It sounds like you're going negative on that.
I was.
Sounds like you're thinking the three is just not that good.
And people say that we're negative sometimes. So.
Well, here's the deal. Getting the three is good. Obviously, you would think on a 14-play drive you're going to get six out of it. But that type of a drive can pay dividends later on because you might wear the defense down.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
They're throwing to start the drive, but that went incomplete. So they'll come up after the incompletion for second down. Here's Rosen. Throw left side complete. That's Drake. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
The last play on the completion got them half of what they needed. Now here's a tough 3rd and 5. They run toss to the right with Drake. And that'll hurt the average a bit, as this time they're able to get him behind the line. A rough go there on 3rd down, a loss of 4. On 4th down, Matt Hawk to punt it away. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. They've shown precious little here offensively thus far as they try again with a 1st down now. Throwing on 1st down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. He was looking for Quincy Anunua that time, but it'll be 2nd down.
But he kind of forced that one there, didn't he? It's almost like he predetermined where he was going to go with the football.
Yeah, he wasn't really going through progressions. He wanted to go to his top guy. You do that against this defense, they'll make you pay, won't they?
Yeah, they certainly will. They react very quickly to the thrown football.
And he'll work this one up to about the 38. They get 6 here after the incompletion, and it'll leave them with a 3rd and 4. Trying to get one more in here before the quarter breaks. After 1, 7-3 the score on EA Sports. 2nd quarter now from MetLife Stadium. The Jets with the football here. They'll come up on a 3rd and 4 here to start things out. Now it's Darnold. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first.
I wouldn't be surprised to see the next step and utilizing this position, he's actually utilized more of a scat back in this spot, because we saw the catch there, right? He made it. He's a bigger, stronger guy, maybe not quite as elusive as maybe someone else you would put
there. Yeah, didn't get the big yardage there. You might not have a smaller back.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive.
And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means they're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here.
So in Jet territory now. Here's first and 10, right at the 40. Now Rosen. Wilson snags it left side. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop it. 25 yards there on the catch and run. Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Mike Gesicki, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Dolphins are able to extend that advantage.
A good tight end is a heck of a weapon for any quarterback, especially when you're able to create some mismatches. Sometimes they work against a linebacker, sometimes they work against a smaller defensive back. But when they find it, they go to it, and it often results in touchdowns.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And from back there, a wise move. He'll just sit on this one, and it'll come out to the 25. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And it's been very much a slow start for them. Three drives and just the 3 points, CD.
Yeah, if you're into the points per drive ratio, that answer is one. And that's not going to get it done in a ball game. They've got to find a way to finish these drives in end zones, not having balls go through goalposts.
From the 30 on second down, Darnold. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
Brandon, it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. Back to throw, Darnold. Open man is Anderson. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. He was the leading receiver for the Jets a season ago, Robbie Anderson, 50 catches, over 750 yards, and getting more and more comfortable with Sam Darnold. Now a year plus under their belts collectively, you'd figure that those numbers for Anderson might be trending further north. They're going to be stopped up on this first down run. He might have gotten back to the line of scrimmage, but that's it. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
Let's go, D-tighten up.
Looking to throw on second down. Darnold. And he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 34-yard line. So the defense blitzed. A nice job picking that up, completing the pass.
And how in sync was the quarterback in his center on that play? They saw the blitz, made the appropriate calls, got the line engaged, because now they know there are going to be extra guys coming at the quarterback, so they got their assignments down pat and kept them away from him, and he's able to step up in the pocket and fire one now for a really good strike.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive here, second and 11. They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete.
That would have been a great catch, but it's real difficult to hold on to it because it was contested all the way. Would have been a great play if he'd been able to haul that one in.
Seventh play of this drive coming up, but a long way to go on third down. Here's Darnold. found his target. It's Anderson. And he gets this one inside the 15, just a yard or two shy of the 10. A really nice gain of 25 yards. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. They'll go back to the ground with Bell. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. A gain of 3, second down.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. Got a man, it's caught. Touchdown, Jets. Quincy Anunua, his fourth touchdown on the year, as his guys are back within a single score.
A lot of people might call this backyard football. Sometimes just understanding who you've got out wide and who you're going to throw it to. Give him an opportunity to go up and make a play, even when contested. Looks like that one worked out pretty well. The trust factor, in effect.
Now after the touchdown, it's Lachlan Edwards to kick it away. This will be taken very short. They're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. At their own 32-yard line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive tunnel.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense getting the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a 3-and-out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang at Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. He's got the first down and more past midfield. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down. You talked about the need for them to establish the run early. They've been able to do that here in the first half.
And that means that the whole offense has adopted that attitude and that persona. We're going to take care of this young quarterback. Let's all get together and run it and take the pressure off.
Now Drake. There he goes again. 20! And he loses the football a second time. And that is going to skip out of bounds. So a break there for sure. They'll hold on to the possession at the 5-yard line. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. They'll run it now. This is Charkandrick West. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. Now from the 7, here's second and goal. A first carry for Samaje Perine. And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Samaje Perine. His second touchdown on the season. The Dolphins are able to extend that advantage. Gonzalez to add the PAT. It's good, and it's 21-10. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. This will be taken near the back of the end zone. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
Ball on the 30, they'll come up with a 2nd and 5. They'll run it with Bell. And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage.
No gain on that run. And while the team is down, there's still time to come back and win the football game. If I'm the offensive coordinator, though, I've got to think about moving at a faster pace and maybe opening things up a little bit and throwing it a little bit more.
Here's Darnold. And that will be incomplete.
But the passing game right now for them, not overly impressive. Last week he hit on right at 50%. This week he's under 50%.
And it's not just on him. Protection, a few breakdowns along the way that's made him get off the spot. Receivers not getting their way open downfield. The coverage has been awfully tight. They've got to all get together and find ways to make this passing game get in gear.
A good return there, call it 13 yards. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half.
Let's go, defense. Hey, man up, deep, man up.
On first down, Drake. And oh my goodness, he loses it again. And it's scooped up by the Jets. Does the big boy have the juice? And he cuts it right and into space. And he is in. Touchdown, New York. Big boy earning his lunch. That's what you call rumbling with the ball, Charles.
Big man with football. He wasn't just earning lunch, Brandon. He was earning dinner. He was
midnight snack.
Everything that you could possibly do, he did it on that play to pick up the ball and go.
The extra point splits the uprights, and it's now 21-17. And you can bet they're preaching two hands on the ball here as the kicks away following that fumble return. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Final play of the half here. It's Rosen. Catch made right side by Wilson. And he'll go down just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. So we've reached halftime here in a four-point game. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! It's been a shootout so far. We'll see which defense can make the adjustments as we get back underway in the second half. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They're close, close game, but they're going to need to do a little bit better probably here in half two, no?
I would agree with that totally. I would guess it in the locker room. They talked about cleaning up some of the errors, but overall, I think they wanted to be positive with them. Guys, we're right there, just not playing as well as we need to. Let's pick it up, and we still have a chance to win this game.
Yeah, they do. We'll see if they can pick it up. And they're going to get him behind the line yet again as his nightmare afternoon continues. Call it a gain of five that time, and they'll be left with a third and about four. From the gun on third down, here's Darnold. And the Dolphins rush gets home. Down he goes.
And we talk about players blitzing all the time. I often laugh and sometimes call it just straight ahead pursuit. What a running start right back to the backfield for him.
Yeah, it really didn't give anybody a chance to get up there and stop him.
No, I mean, that's really, really difficult. You're asking a whole lot anyway, but when he gets that kind of a start and comes through clean, oftentimes the advantage definitely goes to the defensive player.
A big kick there. We'll call it 56 yards on the punt, and it'll be Dolphin football. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they looked out of that lead.
Yeah, how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. Right back to Drake. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. That backs him up 1 yard and brings up third down.
Monday.
On third down, Rosen. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 13 yards as the quick slant keeps the drive moving. They'll look to throw on first down with Josh Rosen. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back. Complete. They'll give him 8 on the play, and that'll bring up second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
From midfield now, here's Rosen. And he hits his target. It's Kenny Stills. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. And that's going to be another first down as the tackle made at the Jets 28.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside. Now that ball delivered with good timing, and they got it done.
His throw caught at about the 5. And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Mike Gesicki, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Dolphins are able to extend that advantage. Gonzalez good on the extra point. And the decision to just kick the extra point winds up successful. Now after the touchdown, here's Gonzalez on to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked
so
well.
Go to something else.
And maybe try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players, and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. To throw is Darnold. A screen to Bell. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Out of the shotgun, here's Darnold. Anunua's got it, complete. 10 yards on the pick up there, and it'll be 2nd down.
Many teams, as soon as they spot man defense, if they haven't called a hitch, they'll get to it as fast as they can. They want to put the ball in the hands of one of their best playmakers and hope that he can break a tackle on the outside and go for big yardage.
Hey, Haywood.
To throw again on 2nd down. Darnold got an open man. It's a noon one. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 38-yard line.
To win any route, you've got to break down the defender, and that's exactly what happened here on this really nicely executed curl route.
So now 1st and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 38. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. 11 more on that one, and another first down. Bell, of course, 3-time 1,000-yard rusher, sat out 2018, but you look back to 2017, a tick under 1,300 yards and almost 700 more receiving. On 1st down, it's Darnold. And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up 2nd down.
That's very well timed there defensively because it's not a bad throw, but the collision came at the exact time he was reaching to bring in the football. Really, really well done.
Decent offense, just better defense. I think you're right. The throw once more on 2nd and 10. Darnold.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Darnold. Darnold and the Jets come up third and long following the sack. Third and long, it's Darnold. He's going to find his tight end. That's Chris Herndon. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 13-yard line.
I know exactly what's going to be said about that play from the defensive perspective.
What's that?
That's why I tell all you guys we need more than one tackler to the ball. He broke the first tackle. Luckily enough, there were more people there to get him down.
Rolling to his right. And this will be caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Josh Bellamy. His first touchdown on the year as his guys are back within a single score. And now they'll empty the backfield here as they elect to go for two. Darnold from the gun. And that one knocked away and incomplete. Nice job defensively on what will be the final play of the third quarter. Now the punter, who also does the kickoff duties, Locke Edwards, out to kick it away. This is fielded a couple yards deep. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25.
The Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own 26-yard line.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They have the lead, obviously, late in the game. I guess the good news for them is if for some reason they would make a mistake, a field goal does the opposition no good.
Everyone loves to have a little bit of a cushion, and that helps you immeasurably. But the bottom line is, do all the things that you're taught in order to close out the game. Don't even let that become an issue.
Yeah, but still a one-possession game. This one not fully over yet. Looking to throw again on second down. Rosen steps away to his left. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
All right, partner, I'm a defender, but I've got to express my admiration there. Moving around, making it happen, and instead of worrying about protecting himself, he goes and gets the first down. I've got to give it to him on that one.
Normally, you don't want your guy taking shots, your quarterback, but it's winning time here in the fourth quarter. If he needs to make those plays with the legs, go ahead, right?
Yeah, no doubt about it. It's, at this stage of the game, all protections, they're off.
2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Well, with the fumble he had earlier, we know how key keeping the football is here. That fumble earlier, probably at the forefront of his mind. Just hold on to this thing.
It's also at the forefront of the mind of the guys who are trying to get the ball from him. And since they've seen him drop it on the ground before, they're doing everything possible to have him do it again. They need that turnover.
And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. Officially, no gain on the play, and they're left with a 3rd and 8. Now it's Rosen. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up 4th down. Critical play in this football game, because if they pick up the first there, that clock keeps rolling.
Has to be a little frustrating for them, because they know that if they pick up a first down there and continue to eat away at the clock, really increases their chances of closing this one out. Now they're likely going to have to give the football up and sweat it out on the sideline.
The field position game often so overlooked, but this offense is going to be backed up deep. What an ideal punt.
And now, this stage of the game, when they need the drive to try and put themselves in a position to win it, you talk about going the long field, the very long field. This could be a 99-yard drive if they're able to accomplish it.
They'll start out on the ground with Bell. And he'll get this only up to about the 3-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8.
Well, he got what he could there, just trying to move forward and gain a little bit of yardage and create some space. You know the pressure is going to be tough defensively.
Come on, come on.
from his own goal line. Darnold. And they're going to sack him again. The fifth time they've gotten him today, and this one results in a safety. Now, the 2 points, that's not totally critical at this point. Still a one-score game, but they do have to give away the football with no guarantees they're going to get it back.
Yeah, or at least if they get it back, will they have any time to do anything with it? So they've got to send their defense out there and say, guys, we got to have it right now. Save some time for us.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a one-score game. And you hear a lot about 2-minute offense and 4-minute offense. Obviously, the 4-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Yeah, really what the 4-minute offense is you're just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays, but it has to be plays that gets first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
But certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure that you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs, keep possession of the football.
Now on first down, Drake again. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Kenyon Drake with his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Dolphins are able to extend that advantage. So what was already a game to remember becomes even more so as that touchdown run, a lengthy one, takes him over 200 yards now for the game.
And I love the fact that to get over 200, it took a pretty good sprint, didn't it? I mean, a lot of times you get 1 or 2 yards, and oh, he's over 200 yards. But that really put an exclamation point on the game he's having. Fantastic. A lot of fun to watch.
This is taken about 7 yards deep. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. And last time they surrendered the safety, we know they don't want to do that again.
That is just one of those oddities in scoring that we get. And it's just so strange to see that go up on the board. And then you got to make sure that that doesn't happen to your team again. They've got to take care of the ball.
But boy, it juices up the defense.
Oh, without a doubt. That's a great way to score some points.
An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. Darnold now to throw. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 16 yards, a first down. Now, correct me if I'm wrong. Yeah, you're down 2 scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full 2-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call 2 plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
Looking for more there on first down, but this throw downfield, incomplete. Here now is 2nd and 10, again from the 41. Darnold off the play fake to Bell. Caught here by Bell. He'll be stopped shy of the 45 despite a great move. Short play like that in this situation this late, that's a win for the defense.
No doubt. I remember something Coach Madden used to talk about all the time. Sometimes you can't just take what the defense gives you. You have to take what you need. And in this case, the offense is taking what the defense is giving them.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down.
This has been a tough one for this offensive line. It appears almost like they've been on roller skates this entire game, the way they've been pushed around. 6 sacks given up in this one.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. Now it's Darnold. Down under 2 minutes to go in this football game. Let's go!
So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. And you'd have to figure they're just looking to burn these final 2 minutes away and get out of here with a victory. They'll run on first down. It's Drake. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Didn't get to the sticks, but that's an ideal carry there on first down, isn't it?
I mean, now you're second and one. Although, you know, in the NFL, even if he picked up the first down, I don't think it's a big difference because the clock doesn't stop.
Yeah, not like college.
Right. If it's college football, you want to – second and one is probably better than picking up the first down because in college football, the clock stops with every first down and actually aids the defense in that situation.
Another yard would probably put this thing in the books. It's second and one. They stay on the ground with Drake. And he'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
Back-to-back good plays have them on the move on first down.
They're not ready for this, man. They're not ready for this. They still playing soccer. Y'all playing the wrong football.
And they will take a knee here.
A loss of a yard brings up second and 11 at the 21-yard line.
So a victory here for the Miami Dolphins, and they were spurred on by a strong performance in that fourth quarter as they held their opponents off the scoreboard.
Everyone wants to pitch a shutout for the entire game, but when you throw one in the fourth quarter, that tells everyone that you're getting stronger and dominance is starting to take over, right? The way that you close, the way that you finish, that gets preached to you from the time you're playing Little League football all the way up through, and they closed them out with a big-time performance.
So for Miami, they move back.